All right, guys, I made it home last night and was carrying all my stuff into the house from the drive and all of that jazz. And I turn around and I see smoke coming out of this corner of the El Camino. And at first I just thought it was steam, like, you know, I'd just driven and maybe it got hot or blew a hose, you know, right? The finish line. Well, that wasn't the case. So the thing about this hot rod has been that the starter itself has been bypassed and had just a wire lead run off of it. Well, last night, I grabbed my luggage out of the passenger door and I shut the door, and evidently it took and grounded out one of these wires here. And I had a little fire. You can see that where the, right through here where it was charring, right across through here, down into the starter, and where we were panicking and pulling the battery terminal off and trying to get everything figured out here. You can see all the bare wire and all the stuff here. So I've got to do a little wiring, or this thing isn't even gonna move anymore. But you can see right here, the charness. So all that drive to get here, and then the El Camino literally was on fire. Made for an exciting little moment. Suck Goof, huh? Goof's the one that came running out and took the terminals off.
Good thing I knew where the pliers were.
Yeah, because it was glowing, huh?
Yeah, it was. It was the only light we could see.
it was bright out here with that, but and smoking. And I had gloves on, so I was trying to tear it all out. I got a couple little burns, but nothing real bad. Thank gosh I had gloves on, because it was cold, so. So now I gotta find out, I gotta find a way to rewire it real quick so it can even move.
Yep.
Shouldn't be too big a deal, but. But evidently something just got jammed right here and melted away. Life's an adventure. Dig it. You learn as you go. See, this ground right here was definitely part of this whole problem, because that thing was glowing. Something just pinched into these grounds here, and that's set this thing ablaze. Oof. All right, so there's the wires down here. Pull these through. Gross. Okay, that one's cooked and broke already right there. Maybe we're just dropping the starter down, wiring it, put it back in. That's what I'm gonna do, because that other crap looks like a bitch. So I need to find a couple ring terminals laying around first, and then just replace those. All right, so I slipped a little rubber hose over this for now until I can get to the shop and start getting things going. I'm just gonna have the one wire come off and then the battery wire tie into that one and not have another wire there like they did. And then I'll just, for now, touch this lead at the end to just the battery itself, so it's not juiced up all the time until I just juice it up. So I'm gonna go ahead and do it that way until I can get to the shop, and then, you know, whether I rig up a new ignition switch, that entire column needs replaced anyway. So I'll probably end up just getting either a new column or figure out how to put in a different style column, and start just rewiring this car, because this car needs a little love. So all right, let's get the starter back in and try to fire this thing up.
Oh, this thing is freaking an engine hoist is for the starter. These things are tanks.
Now, all right, so now I got this one on. Crossing my fingers. Hopefully I got it.
Anything else up. So I've been tracing this wire right here, and I found a little spot right here. I tapped into it
because it doesn't seem to be getting power. If I hold that to the battery and let's try to all right, she still runs. But as soon as I do that, it shuts off. So I need to find out where that wire goes. If it's fused, fix the fuse. If it's broken, fix that. Or I'm gonna have to make some crazy jumper just to do this every time I want to start and stop it. Because it was just this thing. So it has to come down in here somewhere. Keep looking. Oh, what was that? All right, so it looks like it's just still in the ignition switch itself. So I just need to tackle this whole column and get it figured out. But I found another little rod that kind of came undone. Moving that switch around gave me power to the distributor, and getting power to the distributor fired it up. But I kind of think that it's needs water as well. So I need to put new fittings here and here. So I'm gonna run to the store now that I got it running and go get some fittings and try to get this thing all wrapped up so it'll have a heater and can get me to the shop, and then I can get all this other stuff figured out, buttoned up, and working again later. So this is the piece that broke off, and this little arm sits inside here and pushes and pulls with the key. So this is the piece that broke, and what we're dealing with here. All right, I got the water lines on, and it has a heater now. So I just had to put the fittings in the water pump and in the manifold there. So these two hoses here, and that fixed it right up. Whew. Making headway. Next, we're gonna have to put it on the dyno and find out what this thing makes. All right, the Elko is back up and running again. Oh, shouldn't have a fire now. I'll get it to the shop and I'll clean it all up. And then we'll put it on the dyno. We'll try to make this stuff work, and I'm just gonna have to bypass that whole ignition column thing. That thing is just no bueno. It's all busted up anyway. Doesn't seem to work, so. One step closer to getting this thing set up, and I think I'm just gonna swap it, because I'm gonna run through all the wiring, I'm gonna run through all the cooling system, I'm gonna run through this whole car. Hey guys, well, today's adventure with the El Camino. The shifter is now located, yeah, this column is trash. I'll tell you what, hooking up those heater core lines, this thing cranks out the heat now. I should have just took the 30 minutes to 40 minutes and stopped and done it, you know what I mean? But I was worried that it could have been cracked or leaked. Brett had to be home for work the next day, so it wasn't like I could just stop. So, I don't know. I made it, but it was cold. folks. I have missed the shot. Good to see the bully. Vaughn's here, Roger's here, Sean's here, Todd's here, and Jamie. How freaking rad. So if you guys haven't been watching Unknown Journey, Vaughn has just about got everything set up for the... Oh, you changed it? What is it now?
I changed all motor Vaughn speed.
So the Phoenix will be coming back out 2021.
Yeah.
It's going to be rocking.
I have the bullies head in the van too.
Oh, you got the bully heads?
Yeah.
Oh, Vaughn, he's on a mission. I saw the video. You killed him, as usual. Want to take him, check him out? We'll check him out, and then we'll check out our babies.
Yeah.
And get them on the roller.
Look at that. And this intake side.
Oh, dude. It's going to be better than ever.
No, I don't believe it's as much as smooth like polish, you know. Your rough surface is better.
Yeah. Yeah, it definitely is on the intake side. Yeah. Very cool, man. Stoked to see him back.
Wanna bring him in?
Yeah, we'll bring him in and get that stuff rocking. What do you think, James? Start with your hot rod?
No, let's start with yours.
This is an adventure. You ready?
Yeah.
All right. Do you want to see the process?
Yeah, I want to see your starting.
Okay, nobody help me. I just want to show you what I have to go through.
There's no help here.
No, there's no help.
You just drove across the country by yourself. You got it.
Yeah, I definitely got it, but it's a chore. All right, let's start off by showing you all the seriously broken coolness.
Where's the shifter?
So the shifter is right around here. But ends up about here.
Did you just put it between your legs or what?
Unfortunately, I drove the whole way here like that, and I was like, this is frightening. So you gotta get a screwdriver.
Okay.
Turn the key still, because that unlocks the other piece in here. So in the morning, you gotta give her two cranks here.
That was three.
That's right. So whatever, it made it. So let's strap it down and see what kind of jam it makes. You got the paddle, because that's my hood prop.
Did you steal that from Tom?
It is the popcorn paddle. Go back to old Boost Boy episodes. I just figured I was up shit creek, so I needed a paddle. So, you know, I hit a deer at Tom's. Well, there's the hair, so it... And there's some stuck in this light too.
Are you ready to warm this thing up?
I am. Yeah,
here.
My trash.
Let's dust your back off real quick before you get in this fancy car.
Story of my life.
I mean, this is a show car, man.
Show enough.
All right, what's your guess?
142.
Anybody else?
119.
149.
152. 155.
All right.
What'd you say?
Oh, I didn't say anything.
Well, what's your guess?
I'm gonna shoot high, 164. Somebody's gotta be the top of the line here.
Probably 80.
Okay. Yeah. Man, did you? The front wheels are shaking. It's smoking out of a valve cover. Holy crap. Yeah.
I think I might have got third. This might be second round.
Okay. had to get in the gear.
That VTEC draft was looking good. I said 140, so I won the first one. Dang, that's pretty good. Now let's play with some big boy power. See what your hot rod is.
Yeah, we got to unload this big.
Yeah, let's do that too.
The paperweight.
Yeah. That's the bat rod engine. It's from Burnout Rivals. The hole's on this side.
It's seen some better
days. We hit it in the head okay, huh?
We're hoping. That's why we brought it home, because we wanted the cams and cylinder heads. So.
And I mean, there might be a rod or two.
Yeah, there might be a couple rods that we can save and use again.
We can do it as bare engine, you know?
Yeah.
All right, cool. Jump out. Come on.
Jump.
Come on. Come on. Jump. Nope. Sit. Stay.
It hung out with the bully too much. He does not ever listen.
Bully and the curse.
It's wood. Go harder! Go! Go! Go!
Oh yeah.
This thing's fun, man. Here you go. I'll show you my starting process.
I can't wait to see how you start yours.
My starting process, you know.
No, I don't
get
know.
Get in. One, two.
It sounds so good.
There's a little exhaust leak up here, but.
It's got that hollow old V8 sound, you know? That's what won me over when I was a kid.
I took it over to my parents. My dad came out and started it, and my mom was like, oh my God, it sounds like an old car.
It sounds so cool. All right, it's Camino time. Hey, Sammy! First time I've seen her since I got back. She just ninjaed up. What's up, Smokey?
What's up?
Hey. Hey, everybody, here she is.
Yep.
Miss Magical, Miss Wonderful. How you doing?
Good.
How was your flight and everything?
Going good.
Going good? Slept? Chilled?
Yeah.
Yeah? What have you been doing the last few days?
Washing dogs.
Washing dogs?
Yeah.
Dog washings are us.
Yep.
I got your luggage and all your full race gear. We just dynoed the blue one.
Very nice.
Made 150 some horsepower. Not bad.
Jamie's turn.
Yeah. You in on this?
I guess so, yeah.
All right, let's go. Okay, so what's the guesses, everybody?
175.
175. I'm gonna go
188.
I'm gonna go 232.
It's a bigger engine.
It sounds good.
191.
Hit the popper.
Hit the pace car.
Popper.
Oh, look at that.
Oh.
It's got a brawler carburetor. This could be 275, man. It's got the brawler on there. Dang, this just looks way.
See, what? We did the same thing. We did the heater lines.
Oh,
the
yeah.
The lines were already
way
inside.
For
well,
sure.
So see this patch panel?
Yeah.
This is a whole aftermarket unit.
Oh, yeah. I kind of like that.
Down a couple more horsepower because of the exhaust.
Yeah. Man, look at all this rubber stuck to the exhaust from my burnout.
Oh, big, I want to say a big congrats to Amelia Hartford for getting her little K-Series Prius up and
yeah,
moving. That was
saw
pretty
that.
Cool, yeah. She gave me a call the other night and we kind of worked through some bugs. It's pretty cool.
Heck yeah.
Congrats.
Right on.
Oh yeah. That sounds good.
Thank you.
All right, everybody's got their guesses in. 220. Fong says 220. 230. 230. Woo! El Camino! Big old beautiful engine. This is brought to you by Ignite Fuel. No, thanks guys though for all the support and Fuel Tech. So you gonna help me with my K swap? All right.
How fast did that go?
It went almost 70, almost like 62 and a half miles.
Yes, you need another gear.
Make it 220.
Bong wants to win. What did I say? I don't remember.
I
think I said 219.
I said 190, 192. So I was close on the first one.
Yep, you were. It's pretty darn good. Yours doesn't have VTEC.
Now we have an idea what the Elcos make, and we know where to go from here. So we're kind of thinking this one's getting up a setup like similar to what Ruby has.
Yeah, like Ruby's old setup.
The old setup, not the new setup.
Yeah, not the 7 second setup.
A mid 8 second setup.
Yeah.
And the blue one we think we'll just make a driver basically. Yeah. So like 400 horse, 450, 500, maybe somewhere in that range. We'll probably get greedy eventually, but something like that. Just so I can get, 20 to 30 miles per gallon and drive to from work and haul engines around, and it can be my little shop car / my trophy. So
yeah, you come back next year with like Honda engine in it. That's cool, huh?
That is cool, right?
Yeah.
Well, you gotta do a burnout.
Todd said we gotta tie them together.
I think do a bumper pull off.
Yeah, you pull my bumper off.
Well, do you got a hitch?
Yeah, we both got hitches.
Well, that's what I'm saying. Hook it right there.
All right, let's go to the hill.
Pull
off it is. Don't get mad if I drag you across the parking lot, though, dog. All right, today on PFI, we're going to have a pull-off with Jamie. Elco versus Elco. He makes a little more power, but we've got the grip and the winning spirit. That's got to be worth something. Got it. Get us strapped good there, boys.
His hitch fell right out.
Does that mean I automatically win?
Oh, you really didn't have to
really
do much.
I won by default. That's winning right there, bro.
Coming back up.
I stalled it. That's not winning.
And yeah, you gotta press your wires together.
I don't know.
Oh, you had to switch. What?
This car started on fire when I got home.
Oh, that's.
Yeah, you don't know all that.
Yeah, I don't know that.
Now I'm stuck here.
Well, they did say it started on fire before, so.
Really?
that did way better than I thought we would.
Yeah, I thought so too.
What do you think? It was the hat. Honestly, the hat gave me that little edge I needed. I have a little freedom going on.
And then Fong's like, if you quit doing a burnout, you can beat him. I'm like, all right.
Fong, what are you doing? You're supposed to be cheering me on.
You know, he'd like spin the wheel like
yeah,
crazy.
I was going to drag him off. Him into the dirt and go out that way.
He losing the traction, you know?
I just kept rolling gears.
Yeah, you're on a slow speed, so you will pull him.
No, we didn't want him to know.
I mean, look at all my tire.
Next.
Next. Fong versus us both. Yours was just rolling smoke, bro.
Oh, I know. So I was like, awesome. Oh, well, I'm just going to keep doing a burnout.
That was awesome. Thanks for watching. It was so much fun.
It was.
We'll see you guys all tomorrow.
All right, now do that again. That's great.